that Kenya Power has become a nuisance. There is no way that they can always go to Kigati and disconnect power for essential service.
Igeteni TV, Omoeno, Womozi.
Yes. Your Excellency, my name is Calvin Sodera. I work for Western Kenya Water Project, a five-year project fully funded by USAID. And we are very esteemed to be part of this particular process. This is a journey that we've been doing together with other partners. And we are here to commit that as a project, we walk the journey so that we can ensure that the strategies and the aspirations as spelled in the strategy is achieved. Thank you very much.
To ensure that we provide safe water for our people that should be accessible, affordable in terms of the the way we have reached in our economic value right away. Yes, thank you. We have the mandate for us as counties, Nyamira and Kisii, that's why we are talking of Kisii, to ensure that our people in both counties, Nyamira and Kisii County, have access to safe drinking water that should be affordable according to the rates of the current tariffs. Before I hand over the mic, kindly, with your permission, Excellence, we have MDs here, other MDs who have come to witness this great ceremony, this milestone that we have moved. We have the MD Migori.
Guests, visitors, and everybody. Good morning.
Good morning.
I'm Beatrice Kerubo Makwai, MCA Bumbaba Burang Ward, chair of the Committee of Water, Energy, and Climate Change. Let me take this opportunity to thank His Excellence for coming to grace this occasion. I also thank the developers of this important document. May the Lord bless you. Before I call His Excellence to give his remarks, let me see the honorable members of the Water Committee who are here. Yes, that is Honorable Achira Ronald, MCA of the Jawad. Well, thank you. Now, let me take this time to welcome him, the only one, His Excellency Paul Simba Arati, Governor Kisii County. Come and give your remarks.
Wachiria Kodije. Wapi makofi ya Simba, Gavana wetu. Zoni Gavana. Wapi magavana, wapi makofi ya Gavana wetu.
Sorry that I came late. I had a meeting that I was in the morning. I'm having another one right now, like in another 30 minutes before I join another one in HHC, and run into two meetings before 4. And I'll again meet another team to sleep at around 2. Therefore, you'll bear with me, as that has been my business. Was discussing this morning with the chairman, Colonel, and I was telling you, no, yesterday I was at Nyagoroba, that is Mikitutu to Church North. In being there, one of the ladies stood up and she was like, Governor, you came here 2020 when we had this disaster of the landslide. Then you were big. What is happening? You have reduced significantly.
Is it that these people, they have been disturbing you?
I understand. It's not too easy, but we are there. We're making sure we're going to deliver for our people. Allow me. The Chairperson of Water, Environment and Energy Committee, Madam Beatrice, the only one. She's the only woman elected.
A clap for me.
She's the only one elected in Kisii and the Nyamira. That's why she calls herself the only one. Indeed, you are the one. yes. The MCA Bombaba Ward, the County Executive Committee, members who are present, GUWASCO Board members, Lake Victoria, South Representative, Madam Karibu, the MDs, I've seen the Migori, Kericho, Karibuni Sana, honorable members of the County Assembly, Mheshimiwa Chira, who is with us here, the county government officials, Kisii and Nyamira. I didn't see the Nyamira officials who are with us. Nobody recognized them. Nyamira, they are there. There is one who is representing them. There is a problem, and that problem we need to be able to. You know, sometimes when the baby decides to, the baby has grown up, decided to marry, and is forcing the father or the mother to get married, what do? You stop them. No, you can't go engage, seduce the girl, or seduce the boy, go ahead and get married. Therefore, if our brothers in Nyamira gain the want, they are big enough. They can walk on their own. We'll definitely help them get married. We could bring all the gifts at the time of the wedding. Therefore, tell them we have no problem, let them join with us until then, when they have got in their own house to settle in. Therefore, our partners, I'm happy you're saying the representative, my brother, thank you. This is not the first time we met, we've met before. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm grateful for the opportunity to join you in launching the strategic plan for Buzi Water and Sanitation Company, GUWASCO, today. First, let me congratulate the board, the management, and all persons who contributed to the formulation of the GUWASCO Strategic Plan 2023 to 2028 for your hard work, commitment, and progressive ideas. The strategic plan and the business plan we are launching today is within the blueprint around which we intend to make access of water and sanitation services a reality to the people of Gusi, both Kisii and Nyamira counties, especially in the upland areas. I'm aware that the GUWASCO strategic plan has been carefully developed by considering the operational involvement of both counties and charting our strategic focus to deliver on our mandate and Kenya's development aspiration and agenda. This document is a critical communication tool to our internal and external partners, which empowers staff, strategic partners, and the stakeholders at large on what they can hold as GUWASCO accountable for. Importantly, the national and the county journey towards widespread prosperity involves building of a just and cohesive society that enjoys the equitable social development in a clean and a secure environment under the social pillar. GUWASCO and the partner counties are implementing flagship projects under the social pillar, namely foundations for social and economic transformation aligned to Kenya Vision 2030. In this frontier, the strategic plan being launched today shall propel the social pillar aiming to improve the quality of life for Kenyans by targeting a cross-section of human and social welfare projects and programs. Effective implementation of this plan requires adequate resources. To note, while the resources allocated are by no means little, they are hardly adequate to facilitate effective execution of GUWASCO mandate. I therefore call upon our parties, and we want to thank once more USA and other partners. I want to call upon our partners to assist in bridging this gap in order for us to realize even better results. I wish to particularly recognize the effort of county government of Kisii and Nyamira, development partner USA, government agencies like Victoria, South Water Works, Development Agencies, Water Sector Trust Fund, and the non-governmental organizations and the general public for your continued support to GUWASCO. My appeal to all of you is to ask you guys to work with us through this five-year journey and beyond as we all seek to serve this great nation and our counties. On behalf of the county and the GUWASCO, we commit to actively implement the strategic plan and the business plan and provide the required leadership guidance. As I conclude, I take note that the GUWASCO strategic plan envisages a vision of being sustainable and accessible, safe water and sanitation service provider, with a mission to innovatively provide safe water and sanitation services to meet the expectation of our stakeholders. I take this opportunity to ask GUWASCO strive to deliver its mandate effectively for the sake of our customers' satisfaction. We have had complaints of unreliable water supplies from customers and are cases of leakage in our urban areas leading to an increase in percentage of non-revenue water. I hope that with the strategic plan in place, this will be adequately addressed. At the same time, I commend the GUWASCO management for the remarkable improvement in revenue collection from when I came to the office and made it possible that the board was in place and dealt with some cartels who were there, that you improved, and our partners and our boss, Lake Victoria, you can definitely accept that we did cut the runaway corruption at GUWASCO then. Now that they improved from 7 million to 21 million in the last 19 months. Equally, I could have gotten into it, start with the partners here, all the people in the company, and I start getting a million from there or 2 million. Then I leave every person to get. As a result, GUWASCO today has a new team. We join them as staff, so I work with them. I know there's a good number of people on the board. That's what exactly wanted as a people. Of course, there was positions from every quarter on how to get into GUWASCO, and GUWASCO, it was, you know, seen as a lucrative venture where people would want to pocket money. It will not happen unless when I'm not in office. I urge you to seal all loopholes to help raise more revenues to make GUWASCO self-reliant, especially in the settling of electricity bills and the operation expenditure. On matters of electricity, given that the bills are always high, and at the times affecting water supply due to electricity disconnections at our treatment plant, my administration is set to establish a solar plant to help address that issue. While I'm sitting here, I've just thought through that Kenya Power has become a nuisance. There is no way that they can always go to Kigali and disconnect power for essential service, whereas they have not been paid to the county, the U.S. I want to direct the Minister for Finance that write to them, we want also them to pay our debts.
Because there is no way they can always, if there is, even somebody goes to a certain constituency, a member of parliament, puts a street lighting, then we are billed as a county. They don't disconnect that line. They come to treasury where we operationalize it. They switch it off. They go to WASCO, they switch off. Tell them. Tell them. Tuheshimiane. Kama wanataka wacha wafunge pengine lakini sio mahali maji ama hospitali. Why we are getting essential services? They owe us close to 500 million. Na lazima tutafute a debt collector, aende atafute hiyo pesa, atulete, tuwalipe, na wao walipe, na sisi tuwalipe, na sisi tuwalipe. Ada is to sort out that one, because najua kwamba tutakuwa na vita na wao. Ile kitu tutafanya, Madam MD, I think I've asked you before that check, engage, somebody to give us salt to help us pump the water. Later, imagine a pigwa, naika kwa mani, tu achana mambo ya Kenya Power, to some extent. Kwego, again, this week, I'm sure today, you had applied 10 million. For settling for WASCO electricity bills. We were wonderful. WASCO serves both Kisii and Nyamira. I want to ask my brother from Nyamira, have you set any money in it? Because we are paying and you want to walk away. I wish my colleague was here. We have a big problem, but everything is left for Kisii. But then, given that we are the big brother, we must take care of our brother, who is the young brother.
Thank you.
That's our responsibility. I'm happy, Madam MD. I saw yesterday, I approved that 10 million for paying all the debts for Kenya Power. Again, we'll not be disconnected. But as we are doing that, our Gwana or Perry demand not. And ask the county attorney's office to do everything for us to be able to get our money. Good people want to live there. And officially now, what do I do from here? I launched the strategic plan to Nakatawa. And you will allow me to handle them because I have a meeting down here, second floor, where I will be taking around 15-20 minutes. I thought I'll have taken 20 minutes here, but I've taken longer for 5 minutes. And I run to attend other businesses. Otherwise, thank you for our visitors. When you're going back, pass our regards to my colleagues, governors, in your respective counties. Asante sana, Mungu wabariki.
Makofi mazuri kwa His Excellency Governor. Sasa Governor wetu go to cover the MD. 1, 2, count with me please. 1, 1, 2, 3. Makofi mazuri. Thank you so much, Your Excellency. That is the strategic plan. We'll open it. Wapi makofi mazuri. Churu. Sasa takata the business plan, Governor Wetu. Yes. 3, 2, 1, makofi.
I'm going to go to the next one.
Bana ya kitambo, makofi mazuri, makofi mazuri. And His Excellency the Governor for the MD will officially wanapandisha makofi mazuri with our MD Lucy Wanyito. Sante sana, this is wonderful. Basi kufikia hapo, naomba keki kuja hapa mbele. Thank you, Excellency, simame tu hiko. Rich, then officially lead us kukata keki hii.
GUWASCO strategy plan 2023-2028.
Asante sana basi gavana wetu pamoja na MD na Lake Victoria watashike na waziri wetu, chairman wetu amekubali kina sawa. Kata keki. Kata Simba kata.
Kata
Lucy kata.
Kata.
Sante sana Your Excellency, that's good.
Arigato.
Tijeni patiwa.
Igeteni TV. Omwe.